Go for JaspysHobbyland.com. Here we are doing a 8-box quick hit baseball mixer number 4 from JaspysHobbyland.com. Big thank you to all of these folks for getting into the action. Remember, one spot gets you two teams. So let's double up this list right here. Bam, got him. And all the baseball teams are in. There we go. And let's roll the dice for each list. Snake eyes, one and a two. That's it. One and two. That was easy. John C on top and the bottom. And then once again, snake eyes for the teams. One and two. Trades are allowed, so feel free to go ahead and trade it up if you want. Reds on top, Phillies on the bottom. Good to get some baseball going with baseball season underway. All right, so there we go. So, John, you've got the Reds, Lee with the Mariners, Michael Van Wy, Mets, Gabriel, Nationals, Deanne, Diamondbacks, Mary Lou with one of your last spot mojos, White Sox, Chris with the Tigers, Casey, you got the Cubs and the A's, Chris, you got the Cardinals, Deanne with the Astros, Michael Van Wy, you got the Royals, Gabriel, you got the Blue Jays, Mary Lou, Orioles, Brent with the Padres, Mary Lou, Twins, and with your other last spot mojo, Rays. Chris McKeague with the Pirates. Lee, you got my Dodgers. Steve, you got the Marlins. Mary Lou, Angels, Indians, Brewers. Brett with the Red Sox. Steve K with the Braves. Chris with the Yankees. Brett with the Rangers. Mary Lou with the Rockies. Brent with the Giants. And John, you've got the Philadelphia Phillies. So there you go, folks. That was the randomizing portion of the video. Going to pause the video, and when we come back, we're going to see if there's any trades, and then we'll have the break. Boop. All right, welcome back, folks. There were no trades. So the list that we saw on your screen right there remains the same. Let me adjust the focus to get a nicer close-up. There we go. 8-box quick hit baseball mixer number 4. Mary Lou with the last spot mojo stars next to her name. So good luck to her. Good luck to everybody. Good luck to everybody. Everybody. Yeah, yeah. I guess we'll start with this behemoth right here, series 1. Is everyone excited about baseball season starting up? The first week of baseball almost in the books. I certainly have been excited. A lot of expectations for my Dodgers. And let's see if it all comes together. You know, winning a World Series is hard. Winning a World Series is hard. Getting there is hard, and so I hope it just all comes together for the Dodgers. You know, I think Dodgers face an extraordinary amount of injuries last year. I know every team deals with injuries, but look at the Dodgers situation last year. There was a lot of injuries there. And you know, they're starting off 2017 with Rich Hill going on the 10-day DL. They changed it to 10. So that's interesting, an interesting start. But, you know, we'll see. We'll see. Dodgers have a lot of young players coming up the ranks. So, you know, and hopefully, knock on wood, if everyone stays healthy, then the Dodgers should be in pretty good shape to get into the playoffs one way or another. And then from there, let's see what happens. Yeah, well, so far, as Gabriel's pointing out in the chat, Dodgers still Dodgers still unable to hit left-handed pitching. Yeah, hey, Arthur's Diamondbacks have gotten off to a great start. So that's good. Oh, it's always good to have a competitive NL West. I think, really, the Padres are probably going to be the only team not competitive in the NL West, Arthur. Like, hey, listen, I hate the Giants, but I respect them, you know what I mean? Because they've got a pretty good squad, pretty good competitive squad. Diamondbacks, last year's record did not reflect the talent on paper that the Diamondbacks have, so they could be pretty dangerous this season as well. And the only thing Rockies lack, is pitching. You know, I mean, even though their lefty shut the Dodgers down the other night, but listen, Rockies have a great offense, you know. Cargo, Charlie Blackman, Arenado, DJ LeMahieu is could challenge for the batting title every year. You know, so they've got, they definitely have a pop in their lineup. It's just, you got to get that. If that starting pitching ever gets in order, that's going to be terrifying. And the Padres are actually pretty decent too. They traded away a lot of players, but the Padres have a lot of hot young prospects in the lower levels. You know what I mean? So like in single A, they've got a lot of promising players in single A. So they're still a number of years away, but if they can put something together, you know, the NL West could be kind of. I mean, we could be beating up on each other, Arthur, for years to come. It's like, you know, that's kind of the same way. You know, the Orioles and the Yankees and the Red Sox and the Blue Jays all beat up on each other in the AL East. It's going to be like one of those, you know, where both teams can win like 85, 90 games. All right, so let's see. You know what? I forget what we can expect out of here. What are we looking for? Looking for one autograph or... relic card. All right, so we're gonna start off with Seth Lugo, who's actually, I think, doing some pitching. So let me. There's Kenta Maeda. I like these sort of the old school look on those cards. I think there's some cards that are like numbered to like from to 2017, but I'll go through those to check those out. Oh, this is a there you go. Rediscover Tops. These are actually proper buybacks. So like the Kenta Maeda obviously is just in the style of, and then there's the actual buybacks that they included in here. There's Will Myers in that old wood frame set from the late 80s. And this one's just nothing. Will Myers was with the Rays for a long time. Now, there he is again. We're just talking about, see, what perfect timing. Will Myers, we were just talking about you. There he is. Will Myers was going to be a bust, basically. Like there were so many expectations on him, but everyone said he was going to be a bust. And in San Diego, everyone thought, hey, no, forget it. He's done. He's just going to waste away in San Diego, and there goes his career. No one's going to remember him. Fernando, nice, but turned out to play pretty well. Got himself a nice contract, so good for him. We're talking about Nolan Arenado, league leaders. There you go, Jaime Garcia. Masahiro Tanaka, who I heard recently that if he opts out of his deal, because I think he can opt out or his deal ends soon. The Yankees don't plan to extend him. It'll be interesting to see how that plays out. He's good when he's, you know, he's good on his day, you know, but the issue is that I think he has like a tear in his elbow. People are saying that his arm could fall off at any time. You know, it's like, do you want to be the GM who signs Masahiro Tanaka to an extension? Mookie Betts in the old style. And then the actual buyback. Mike Trujillo. Some classics there. This is just a advertisement right here on the back. Jacoby Ellsbury is pretty decent, but he's just getting paid way too much. Marcia, oh, thank you. Let's see what else we have here. So the one relic per box has been pulled. There's Marcelo Zun, who's also pretty solid. It's Goldschmidt. Yeah, I guess he is a five-tool player, isn't he? He's pretty solid. Got him on the fantasy team. Steve Farr, that old 89 set. Chris Sale, good start for the Red Sox. That one will go to the White Sox, though. David Price, Roberto Clemente, scan through these really quick. Tom Lawless, card, what is this? This is the 88 set right here. All right, boss man, I'll see you. Have a good day. I'll see you on Tuesday.
You got it, man. Have a nice weekend.
Thanks, you too. We're off tomorrow, folks. Keep that in mind. We don't break on Sunday. So Jason Jaspy will be back dual streaming on the hockey channel and the main channel on Monday. He'll do all of your main channel break needs. He'll also break some hockey too. And then I'll be back on Tuesday. So we break Monday through Saturday. Oh, nice. Joe Carter. There you go, that's pretty cool. Kyle Schwarber, Future Star, and Tanaka at the end. There you go. Go. We'll do a couple boxes of 2015 Panini Prism Baseball. We're looking for two autographs per box on average. Well, thanks, Brad. So between these two boxes, we should see about four autographs right here out of these, so keep an eye out. This is 2015 Prism Baseball. We should see some different parallels. I forget how many parallels are in here. We should see some parallels as well. Who's my favorite Blue Jays player? Do I have a favorite Blue Jays player? It would probably be Edwin Encarnacion, but he's on the Indians now. I like Stroman. I like Marcus Stroman. I like Roberto Osuna. Although he's on the DL right now, I think. Or maybe if you go old school Blue Jays, maybe you go Dave Steeb is a good old school Blue Jay. Didn't John Oliver play for the Blue Jays for a while? I think he played for everybody. Yeah, Carlos Delgado's a good old school Blue Jay. The Jays are facing the Rays right now. Nice. I'm sure that's a highly rated matchup right there. The entire country is stopped to watch. Is that on national TV? Everyone stopped to watch that matchup. Although, unless Chris Archer's throwing. Chris Archer's pretty fun to watch. All right. Here we go. There's Will Myers. Tulo's a good Blue Jay. Frank Thomas refractor. James McCann. And we've got Ichiro. Nice. 132 out of 199. Camo refractor. Marlins edition of Ichiro. Steve K. And is that an autograph? Nice. That's my boy, Jock Peterson. Nice one for the Dodgers. That's a rookie auto of Jock Peterson. Lee. Nice one, Lee. I like the Jock Peterson. There's Tony Gwynn. Good man, Tony Gwynn. Gabriel, you might know. You ever listen to the post-game show on the radio for the Dodgers? His son, Tony Gwynn Jr., co-hosts the radio show. And it's freaky because dude sounds just like his dad, right? It always trips me out. 132 out of 149, Salvador Perez, Royals. Verlander. Nice, tie-dye, Didi Gregorius. Out of 50. Nice. For the Yankees, going out to Chris McKeague. He'll be back early May, I think. I think he's still kind of getting his shoulder healthy. There's the big unit. Edwin Escobar and Yasmani Tomas. Oh, nice. Out of 125, kind of have that X-Fractor look in the background, Deanne. Deanne has the Diamondbacks. That's on card as well. All right, so those are your two autographs. And there's Tulo, Rockies edition. Part of the 42 set, 14 out of 42. Buster Posey, Brian Dozier. Slide those base cards over here. And we'll sleeve these guys up right here. All right, so it's nice. And a West box. Booney's saying, oh, Gary Sanchez went down for the Yanks here with a hand injury. Doesn't look good. That's not good for a catcher. Probably not. All right, this is the second box of 2015 Prism Baseball. Good start so far. There's David Wright, the captain. Captain America, 17 out of 42. Oh, right, part of the 42 parallel. And Raul Ibanez, 32 out of 49. Nice blue auto for the Mariners. That'll go to Lee. Lee with the Mariners. There's Chase Utley. And orange, 44 out of 60, Ryan Braun. For the Brew Crew, that'll go to Mary Lou with the Brew Crew. There's Brian Dozier. Manny Machado, Dalton Pompey, refractor. Corey Kluber again. And Ryan Rua for the Texas Rangers. Nice refractor auto for Brett. Danny Santana for the Twins. Camo refractor out of 199. There's Yachty right here. Remember how the baseball got stuck to his chest protector right there? I remember. That goes to the Cardinals. That goes to Chris. There's Dalton Pompey again for the Blue Jays out of 149. Jake Arrieta. Blue Jays, that's for Gabriel. And that is that. There's Jose Abreu right here. All right, folks, let me sleeve these guys up and we'll move on to, we'll get to some tier one. That's what we'll do. Right. I think everything ships, doesn't it? I'm pretty sure everything does. All right, we're going to start off with, are these, that's an auto, that's an auto, that's a relic. Start off with the relics. How about that? Brian McCann, 6 out of 50 for the Yankees, dual relic. That'll go to Chris McKeague. And then Ichiro out of 199 relic going to the Marlins, Steve K. Your autographs is Mike Matheny, 20 out of 249 with the classic John 3:16 inscription in there too. His only begotten son and whatnot. That's a popular one. It's kind of a trendy one, right? There's Mike Matheny. And that's for the Cardinals. That'll go to Chris. Cardinals, right? Yeah. Right? Yeah, he played for the Cardinals for like ages. Yeah. Cardinals, that goes to Chris Paradiso. And then we've got Chris Heston at a 299. Didn't he throw a no-hitter? Oh, yeah. There you go. For the Giants, Oppo Joe Mojo for Brent. All right, let's go tribute. Now, this is 2016 tribute. If you want to do 2017 tribute, isn't it? It's in the store right now. JaspysHobbyland.com. Check it out. Pick your teams. And this is actually fun because you can see what the... you can actually see the differences between the two sets. All right, I forget how the configuration to this goes, so I think I'll just do it this way. There's Nolan Arenado, Felix Hernandez. So last year, they kind of really put a very bright refractory finish on the front of the cards. But in 2017, you can kind of see they put a kind of a flatter plastic sort of finish on top of it. I have to admit, I like both. There's Ian Kinsler. There's Joey Votto and Tony Perez. There's Bob Feller, that feller right there, and Matt Kemp. What's up, Michael G? There's Willie Stargell and Sonny Gray. And then we have, what's going on here? Oh, there we go. Burt Blyleven and Hoyt Wilhelm for the New York Baseball Giants. I'll go to San Francisco, obviously. 18 out of 50 on that. So similar configuration in that there's like one numbered card and then a bunch of nice looking base cards, and then these are the hits right here. Oh, you're welcome, Michael G. I'm glad we rallied and got that done last night. First one is nice. Paul O'Neill. 69 out of 99. Paul O'Neill autograph. Yankees edition going out to Chris McKeague. Nice one. Fins up. Like I said, we have 2017 in the store right now, JaspysHobbyland.com. Nice. 2 out of 5. Miguel Cabrera stamp of approval with the hologram sticker HZ, as in zebra, 793-495. That's awesome. Who has the Tigers? Chris Paradiso with the Tigers. Out of fives and under means you're all aboard the Big Hit Express. Woo-hoo! Nice hit. Gotta have a Henry Owens in here. Rookie auto out of 199. Going to the Red Sox, Brett with that one. We were just talking about Carlos Delgado. 20 out of 50. Carlos Delgado for Gabriel and the Blue Jays. Nice. Nice one, man. And Ron saying that the jersey of the Miggy, he looked it up on MLB.com/authentication. Game used jersey. It was Twins against the Tigers on April 6th. April 6th, what, one? What is that? April 6th, one. The year one? Wow, I didn't know Miguel Cabrera was out. Oh, 2015, says Alex Hewitt. He looked it up. Someone look up the box score. How did he do that day? Corey Kluber relic, 19 out of 199. JB307258. These are fun to look up. You can see if Corey Kluber made a start, see how he did, et cetera, et cetera. All right, and the last one is Hall of Famer Rod Carew, relic, 132 out of 196. They named the AL batting title after him, Angels. That goes to Mary Lou. There you go, Mary Lou. Bam. All right, let's see what's in here. One encased autograph per box. I'm peeking. And this one is also for Mary Lou. She has the tribe. Nice. And that is a 1 out of 10? Yeah, 1 out of 10 Sandy Alomar autograph. Nice. Nice one for Mary Lou and the Indians. And the Corey Kluber swatch was from 2015. Cleveland Indians versus the Pittsburgh Pirates. All right, so let's see who gets these. So I'm going to number these. That's one. And that's two. So the first person on the randomizer will get this one. The second person on the randomizer will get this one. Alex Hewitt looked that up, and unfortunately, Miggy went 0 for that day. Okay. Well, you can't win them all. Sometimes they have really, really good games. But it's always worth looking up every one of those because you never know. Okay, so let's go back to the team list. So let's go with Deanne all the way down to Gabriel. Let's get them on a new list here. Let's roll the dice. So top two, we'll get it. I'll open up right now too. Three times this time, one and a two. One, two, and three. The names on top, Chris McKeague and Brent Holbrook after three times. Nice. So Chris, you get number one. Good luck. And it's going to be nice. A silver ink autograph of Edgar Martinez. 69 out of 99. Nice. The look on Edgar's face suggests that he could be contemplating the fruit of his 18-year career in Seattle. Yeah, he does look very... very lost in thought, doesn't he? Just very reflective, looking off in the distance, somewhat pensive. All right, nice one, Chris. Next one is for Brent Holbrook, who has envelope two. And we got some LA on there, little Dodger Joe Mojo. Bam, Mike Piazza, silver ink autograph, nice. Good old Mike Piazza. That is 18 out of 20. Wow. Hall of Famer Mike Piazza. So pissed when they traded him. There you go. And that was a nice break, ladies and gentlemen. That was Jaspy's 8-box quick hit baseball mixer number 4 from JaspysHobbyland.com. Keep looking to our website for more fun mixers and whatnot. And baseball and basketball. We could break it all. JaspysHobbyland.com. This is Joe. I'll see you later.